Hey folks, welcome back to Build It with Smith. I'm your host Smith, and today we're going to be taking a look at how to boost your population. Now this is just a quick sort of video format. We're just going to be taking a look at some of the best practices that I use when boosting my population. Now here's my city, and here's my population, 224,000. Now you see that you can maintain and boost your population by providing services. And there's a lot of different services that you can provide. Right now already I got the grade school, which is part of the education services, and there's a lot more that I can choose from. Today I want to take a look at the parks, because there's lots of parks if you haven't taken a look. So in this little section right here where I have the Ramirez apartments and all these other apartments here, it's providing 485 more Sims to my population. So that's the boost it's getting. And now it's gone. So I'm going to see, is it better to bulldoze a building and replace it with a park to affect a greater amount of buildings, or should you just put as many buildings as you can? Now, like I said, there's a lot of parks to choose from. I'm thinking about this one. That jogging park was going to give me 30% population boost, but let's scroll through. There's also this one, which I kind of like. The geometric park looks pretty nice, but I think for the price, we're going to go with this jogging park. Now, look, this is going to give me almost double the population boost, and it's not even boosting all the buildings that it's touching, like those service buildings there, the fire station, police station, and health clinic. They don't boost your population. So, but I think it looks really nice, and it's adding more than I had before. Now let's look over here in this section. Here I got some mid-story apartments. This one right here is providing 2,210 more population. So we're gonna see if, well, not that one. Maybe I can go back to that geometric sculptures. Now let's see. Oh, this is getting me slightly more population, but look at how the population data layer is orientated. It's kind of going like this rather than outwards. So this isn't getting as much as a population boost as I thought. So with this sort of thing, I wonder if I put it over here, would it affect these taller buildings that I have? Like the skyscrapers there. Not quite, only 525 more with that. So I think we're gonna move it back the way it was before. And that's kind of what you gotta do. You can see that I'm getting a lot of different population boost all the way around the map. And this is just the parks, ladies and gentlemen. This is just the parks. We also have the beaches that are providing a lot of population. And right now I kind of have them all not really in a certain order. I need to do something with that. But the thing about the beaches is they go long ways with their population. So that's it, guys. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time.